Galley cat?
Gawker.
Slut.
He's been out twice already.
Thanks. It's Jack Bauman's office. Oh, hi, Morgan. Yeah, I'm sure he did read them. No, I did. I thought it was amazing work.
So glad you could make it. If you've got a minute, let's go through my day.
You know, I'm sure that he would love to talk to you, but he's in a meeting right now.
And don't forget to change my shrink appointment.
Got it.
Oh, I need you to manage another release for me.
There's nothing scheduled for months.
It's for the e-book of Waking Eyes. We're tying in the new edition.
I thought that was coming out next fall.
Spot opened up on Charlie Rose. We're moving it up. I thought you'd be the perfect person for the job.
What?
Well, your father's Milan's agent, right?
Yeah, but,
They sent me the arcs. You got a list from publicity. Let's put our heads together. Alice. All right, look, I know it's not glamorous, but I'm putting my trust in you. Waking Eyes is the bestseller on our backlist. All right, look, what if I read that manuscript you've been hounding me about?
You will?
Yeah, what's the girl's name?
Karen Malone.
Yeah, Karen.
Malone.
Okay.
It's the best thing that I've read since I've been here.
I said I'd read it.
Okay, but we have to hurry because there
yes,
might be some
Alan Mitchell, please. He's busy? Huh. Well, fuck him. No, I don't want to leave a message.
So you'll read the manuscript this week?
Yes.
You're doing the Waking Eyes release?
Do you know they were moving it up?
Yeah. That's the book that made me love books. I totally identified with her. Didn't you? Alice?
Well, it's a fancy book.
Nice to meet you.
No, it's just come up with you, see. And this was a long trip.
Hey, sport! You're having a good time?
Sure.
Yeah, say hi to everyone.
Hi.
Alice wrote a terrific short story last week. She's gonna be the real deal. Oh, this is Milan Doniker. This is my daughter, Alice.
Hi.
It's a pleasure to meet you.
Milan's one of your mother's undiscovered writers, but he's written a book, a good book, and I'm gonna make sure it sells.
Yes, please.
Yes. Yes.
Gotta meet Annette.
All right.
Times book review.
Okay.
Play a little of that song, charm. Yeah.
She dodged the forced laughter and the vapid conversations. If she could just...
Oh, sorry. I was just looking around and...
It's okay.
Can I? Really? So, how is it to grow up like this?
It's a little lonely.
That's what I thought, yes. And you're a writer too, yes?
I don't know.
I would like to read your story.
It's nothing.
Why don't you let me decide?
If she could just make herself small enough. completely unremarkable.
She is late as usual. We were just discussing that this new film with, what's his name? Flavor of the Month, you know who
I mean.
Oh,
yeah.
Have you seen it?
Yeah, Sadie and I went to see it last weekend, actually. Mm-hmm.
And?
We kind of enjoyed it.
Oh, I thought you were smarter than that. Did you know Alice won a Scholastic Writing Award when she was 16?
Really?
Oh, we'd like to order now. What do you have, sport? Oh, get the beef cheeks. They're fabulous here. She'll have the beef cheeks. And you?
Pasta puttanesca.
Well, I'll have the puttanesca. You have the grilled chicken. Maya?
She'll have the grilled cheese.
No. A half order of calamari and some fries for her. Yeah. Make it a whole order. Kids love fried stuff. Here's to you, pal.
Oh, what are we celebrating?
Independent booksellers love the book. Word of mouth is fantastic.
Thank you.
Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
Oh, I love watching you eat.
I know.
You must. You invite him to dinner every night.
Anna.
That's great.
So, here's to me. I discover talented writers, develop them for years, and then you steal them away from me.
Anna, you told me to get a new agent.
We're getting some great press in the trades. Milan is making headway on the next one, right? Mm. Right?
Yes.
I'm talking to you.
You're drunk.
Fuck you.
Your command of the English language is astonishing.
Fuck you.
I think you said that already.
Cursing was one of the first words I knew in English.
Really? Who taught you?
The kid next door.
Excuse me. I'm going to go freshen up.
Delicious, huh?
Delicious.
I'll do it. Oh my God, look at you.
Hey.
What are you doing here?
I just finished my first draft of my new book, so I'm here to deliver it.
Are you kidding? We would have sent someone.
It's better in person, isn't it?
Congratulations. Finally, something worth reading.
Thank you.
Come into my office.
It's been far too long.
Hey, where'd you go?
I'm coming.
Finally.
Alice, where's my lunch?
Chez Louis, 1 p.m.
If I'd known you were going to drop by.
So, but maybe I could have lunch with Alice.
What?
To celebrate.
I can't. I've got...
You have to eat.
I really need...
You could toss around some marketing ideas.
You know what?
She'd love to.
Please.
How are you?
Good.
Good, good. Good. So you're organizing the release of the new edition, yes?
Ironic, huh?
It's nice. Tell me about your day.
You know, school. How is yours?
You know, writing. I'm glad you could meet me.
Thank you very much.
When can I read your story?
It's like no big deal. They just printed it because no one really submits stuff, and they're kind of desperate.
Come on.
This line here is exactly how it feels like the first time you see someone that you maybe love. It's, you're a writer. What about your writing?
I'm mostly not.
That's a shame.
I read your new bio. Says that you're teaching a lot.
Yes, I enjoy it.
I'm sure.
You were my first and best student.
I gotta go.
Alice, I missed you.
Why don't you just say, hey, about that little thing that happened 15 years ago that you never owned up to or apologized for like you should have, you motherfucker. Sorry, Tyler.
Okay, I should never have told you. Look, it's not a big deal.
But he hurt you, Allie. You don't do publicity for someone who hurt you.
It's my job.
I thought your job was to help find and edit new and wonderful novels.
Tell that to Jack.
Why don't you?
Will you help me?
Besides the fact that I think it's a terrible idea, what could I do?
You're a successful web designer.
Alice.
Okay, fine. You're a semi-successful web designer whose best friend thinks she's brilliant.
Yeah, who gave up her not-so-stellar career to be a mommy.
I need to build more of a web presence for the book.
Oh, that's a great idea.
Sadie, please. Don't make me do this alone.
You're real shit, you know that?
Thank you. All right, I need to go and wrangle a radio spot. Yay.
We didn't get to talk about what you want to do for your birthday.
Hide in a closet until it's over.
Right, you better have a big closet.
You promised. Come here, buddy, give me a hug. I gotta go.
Hugs. Alice, why are you always running off somewhere? You don't want to go.
Oh, fuck off.
Sorry, Tyler. All right.
Bye, call me later.
I will.
Hello?
It was a graceful pas de deux, a dance of hate. He belittles her, 2-3. She yells, 2-3. It's me. This is the new story. I'm not really sure about the ending. It feels really forced, and some of the dialogue is really bogus.
Do you have a pen?
Yeah.
Thanks.
Can't watch.
Is that your homework?
Yeah. I have like 100 pages of American history.
Come over here, kiddo. Come. Let's read together. I wouldn't bother if it wasn't good. But it can be better. It's too abstract. It's, so it only becomes real if we give it concrete details. Concrete details. Look, here. It's too abstract. If you move that one. Here we go.
Okay, so who has material to hand out for next class? I need one more volunteer.
I brought in some new pages.
Alice?
I have this really radical idea for this super weapon the Zorgotes are going to use to destroy planet Earth. Just wait till...
It doesn't have to be complete. Maybe we could give you some ideas, or...
Well, if she doesn't have anything...
Sorry.
Okay, Josh, what are those aliens up to?
Look at that view. It's beautiful. So... Come. So tell me about your day.
School.
School?
It's the same every day. Totally boring.
Well, not for me, you know. For me, it's like a movie. Cheerleaders, boys and team jackets holding hands.
No.
No?
Mm-mm. People don't hold hands anymore. They just hook up.
They hook up?
Mm-hmm.
Hook up.
And, no cheerleaders. No, I guess we do have uniforms, but...
Like uniforms? Yeah. Yeah.
My best friend Ruby just went golf.
She turned what?
Golf.
Golf?
Mm-hmm.
Golf?
You know, what? like black eyeliner and ripped shirts.
Oh, yeah.
And her mom would freak out if she knew. So she hides her stuff in the hallway every day before she leaves. And,
Yeah.
And
yeah.
You want to hear about this?
Oh yeah.
Well, she says
her mom has no idea who she is anymore, but maybe she never did.
Yeah. So Thursday's a good day for you?
I guess so.
Okay. See you next Thursday, then.
Sorry, guys, I know you're wasting precious babysitter time. I just want to eat in front of the TV and get sodden and pathetic.
It is your day. We will do whatever you want.
Thank you.
Surprise!
I knew you were going to make us bring you home.
Thank you. Happy birthday.
Oh. You're really gonna enjoy it once you're used to the idea.
Come on, help her blow it out.
1, 2, 3.
Oh, get the odds.
Yay, oh, last one. Homework.
What?
What's your writing?
My journal.
Come on. I want to know you.
I can't.
One page. My heart is pounding. I have to get up.
That's okay, I was reading.
Sorry, No, I was just looking for a place to hide out. My friend invited me. I don't even know the girl this is for. Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Well, happy birthday.
Shh, I'm trying to pretend like I don't have to grow up.
Is there anything I can do to help?
Maybe.
Yeah.
That's good.
So what are you reading? Oh, I love that character. Female Holman Caulfield.
Yeah, that's what they say.
Not a favorite?
No.
So, why are you sitting alone in a bathroom on your birthday reading it?
Work.
What do you do?
That is not an age-appropriate question.
You're right. I'm sorry. Want some? birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear
Alice.
Happy birthday to you. Oh, Emmett.
Hi.
Thanks for inviting me.
Yeah.
Wait, you two know each other?
He was Rob's freshman year roommate. No, I actually met him first. Freshman mixer.
All right.
You're kidding.
No.
Okay, college, wow.
Let me help you up.
Thank you.
Oh, can I help with the cleanup?
No, no. No, we got this. You've done enough.
You recycle?
I plead the fifth.
What about your mom?
She stayed home with us. Do you have sponges?
Sorry.
Yeah, they've been married 35 years. Sometimes happily, sometimes not. They're abnormally normal.
Wow, you're like some kind of almost extinct species. They should breed you in captivity.
So, aside from not being environmental activists, what's your family like?
Not much like a family.
And?
Nuts.
Oh, that explains it.
Thanks.
Look, just so we're clear, I don't really do nuts.
I'll keep that in mind.
So while he was building a Bionicle, I posted on New Yorker Books, Paris Review, Gallicat, what else?
How am I gonna thank you?
I don't know. Foot massage.
Not too high, Ty.
So Alice grew up and became a wife and mother just like everybody else. Isn't that sad?
Yeah. But it would make me sadder if she hadn't.
Face is chapped. When you're near 30, you have to moisturize, trust me.
Kissing.
What?
Too much kissing.
Never say that to a married person.
Guest.
Look at you.
Yeah.
I'm so glad.
It's terrifying.
And exhilarating.
Mom!
Yeah, what is it, baby?
Jesus Christ. Mom!
Okay. Dad?
God, I need a jacket for this thing tonight. Here, this was in the middle of the living room.
It's not mine.
What? Well, where the hell did it come from? God, it reeks.
I think it's Milan's.
Milan's?
He was here this afternoon.
What? Did he bring by a new draft, or?
He came to see me.
You?
Yeah. He's been helping me with my writing.
What? Since when?
A while.
Well, you couldn't have a better mentor. You were a lucky girl.
Yeah.
I expect great things of you.
Okay, here. So this lady, she hasn't voted in 20 years. She starts reading our most outrageous quotes of the day, sees her senator waxing poetic about the benefits of hydrofracking, immediately promises to volunteer for anyone who will run against him.
Wow.
And this guy, oh my God, I love the way they curse in the South.
You too realize you're a fanatic, don't you?
Yeah, sorry. Mm. You want some of my pecora?
Yes, I want to try your pecora.
I proofed your entry, so you can post at any time. I'm the last one here, so I'm gonna head out. See you tomorrow.
Bye.
Bye.
Thank you.
It's nice to know somebody who actually likes what they do. I always wanted to be a writer when I grew up.
Are you?
Grown up.
Writing.
No.
How come?
I sit there waiting to hear the characters speak, and instead I have this voice in my head saying, this is shit, this is shit, this is shit.
And that voice? Everybody hears that voice. That's the same voice that says, I can't believe you just said that, you fucking moron. Everybody hears that voice.
You think?
Yeah. Most people just ignore it.
Really? I just succumb.
Yeah? I like a girl who knows how to succumb.
Really?
Really?
Well, good morning. This is a new jacket copy?
Yeah.
Great.
I thought
Can you get Harold Blake for me?
Did you get a chance to read Karen's manuscript?
Not yet. The Fisher book's exploding.
But you will this week.
As soon as I get a free moment. Now, Milan did an interview with the press office. Can you see if he said anything we haven't heard before?
This week?
I'm sorry?
This week.
Oh, yes, of course. I really need to talk to Harold.
Harold's on line one.
The only real rule of good writing is generosity.
Rule number one, generosity. You must be willing to share yourself. Oh, I brought you a present.
You did?
Yeah. It's a birthday present. I wrote you a poem.
I didn't know you write poetry.
No, I don't, but you inspire me. So, go. What do you think?
It's nice.
Nice?
Yeah, I have a pre-calc test tomorrow. Jesus, I hate this stuff.
That is.
It's okay.
Okay. I'm glad you liked the poem.
Anything we can use?
Nothing that we haven't heard before.
Damn. Get me Susan at Simon & Schuster.
Sorry.
So are you ever on time?
No, but,
thanks.
Alfred Marx began working at the White House at the age of 28. Good for Alfred. Louise Vanderspot.
Okay, stop.
Stop.
What?
Is this what you do every Sunday morning? You just sit here and envy other people's lives?
No, that is pretty much a full-time occupation.
You know it's pointless, right?
Yes, I do. You can't write in front of me.
What?
No, I'm serious. If anyone's gonna write in my apartment, it's gonna be me.
But you don't.
Thank you for pointing that out.
Come on. It's not like there's a finite number of words in the room, and if I use them all, there won't be enough left for you.
Why does everything you say have to make so much sense? It's fucking infuriating.
Well, perhaps simply I put it similar. So. That was it.
Seeing anyone special, sport?
Not really.
You know, having children. Most satisfying thing life has to offer.
Yeah.
How's the writing going?
No, you know. There is a book that I read that I thought was terrific.
Yeah?
Yeah, I'm trying to get Jack to read it.
Yeah?
Well, I thought that maybe you would have a look. Maybe you want to meet with the writer.
Jack hasn't read it?
No, don't worry about that. I'll get him to read it. I just thought you might want to meet with her. Her name's Karen Malone. She did Iowa. She has this amazing short story.
No, I'm going to call him up.
No, Dad, please don't. That's not what I meant.
Well, I can fix it.
Dad?
Sport.
Dad, I'll get him to read it. I just wanted your opinion.
Okay.
Dad, I mean it. Don't call him.
Okay, honey, I won't call him. Hey, Tiger. Are you having fun? Huh?
Great work. Alice, can you hang out a minute? Look, do you want me to refund your tuition?
What?
It's past the official deadline, but I could ask them to make an exception.
It's not that I'm not trying.
Why don't you sign up again when you feel like you're ready?
Yeah, I know he's doing a lot of press right now, but it would be great if he could squeeze in the Waking Eyes River release party. Okay, no, I don't have any confirmations yet, but I can hold. Is this Jack Bauman's office? Yeah, is he expecting you? Karen Malone? Karen, hi. I'm Alice. Nice to meet you. It's really nice to meet you, too. So could you tell him I'm here?
Hey, Karen. Come on in.
Hi.
Jack Baum.
So nice to
pleasure
meet you.
Pleasure
to meet
you. Alice. Have a seat.
Hi.
Dad?
Am I late? See, sport? I told you I'd fix it, huh? Can I take you to lunch when we're through here?
Ben?
Hey.
Good to see you.
Keith, I'm watching Tyler.
Oh, okay.
We were at the park all day. He's taking.
Well, I'm Alice.
Yeah. Hi.
Hi.
Sadie's at prenatal yoga. She'll be back in like an hour and a half.
Maybe you could just tell her that I came by. She could call me.
Yeah. Sure.
Okay. Well, you know what? Actually, maybe I'll just check on Tyler. If that's okay.
Yeah. Sure. Come on. We read this in my modern lit class last year.
Oh.
I didn't finish it.
Well, you can have that copy if you want.
It's kind of dated. What?
Doing?
Oh, what are you doing at home?
I decided to skip deep relaxation. Is there someone in there? Keith, get out of here.
Okay. You owe me 40.
No.
Okay.
What the hell are you doing?
I don't know.
He's a kid.
I know.
If Tyler had woken up, oh my God, he would have been so confused.
I know.
What about Emmett?
I know. I don't know.
Hey, honey. Yeah, baby.
I'm Alice.
Alice has to leave now.
Still waiting on that updated guest list.
I'm working on it. You could have told me that you read it, that you liked it.
That we're publishing it.
You are?
I thought Daddy would have spread the word.
Well, who are you assigning it to?
I'm editing it myself.
It's not your kind of book. I found her.
Alice, that's your job. You call the good stuff. I decide if it's good enough.
Yeah, but listen, I have some great ideas.
Now, listen, there's no way I'm going to let an inexperienced editor work with an inexperienced writer.
I've worked here for 2 years.
And how many books have you edited?
My point exactly.
I will CC in my notes. You can come to me with your thoughts anytime you like. Now, listen, Milan is expecting you at the taping tomorrow. The new novel is almost unreadable. Make sure he sticks to Waking Eyes, okay? You're the best.
So, 15 years, you've written 7 novels since Waking Eyes, and none has become a kind of cultural icon.
No, unfortunately not.
What do you think makes it so perennially popular?
What I think it is that everyone has been a teenager and we all know how out of kilter it makes.
Okay, so are you gonna tell me a secret now?
All right, I think we actually came here because no one can hear this, actually.
Yeah.
Bye.
I have to go.
So go.
So the question I have to ask,
which I probably have answered many times before, so go ahead.
Possibly. How does a man in his 40s perfectly capture the essence of a teenage girl?
This opening paragraph is self-indulgent. 95% of writing is rewriting, you know that. And here's another dangling preposition. The way you mangle the English language is, look at this. I'm the immigrant here.
I was hanging out with my friend, I forgot. I'm sorry.
I do this because I believe in your talent.
I know.
Come here. I do this because I love you.
I know.
Yeah.
I met a boy.
Oh, I'm happy. So glad. I want you to be happy. What can I do to make you happy?
We all like a mystery, but there's no Mr. Girl in it. It's all fiction. And that time I did walk around in the city and listen in on subways, coffee shops, streets, you know, and I still do now and then listen in to see if girls have changed, you know. Yes.
And have they?
Something never changed.
Hi.
Oh, hi.
Special delivery.
What the hell are you doing here? No, you need to go. I have somebody coming here.
Another time?
No.
Why?
Look, I just turned 29.
Really?
And I guess it messed with my head. Shit. Hey.
Hi.
This is Keith.
Yeah?
He's Sadie's babysitter.
Yeah?
You her husband?
No.
Keith was just leaving.
Sorry. Yeah, sorry, man.
Add us some wine.
Alice?
I went to Sadie's the other day and I forgot that.
And?
Well, I told him that he could borrow it.
Before or after you forgot it?
Emmett.
Did you?
Fuck.
Emmett, can we just talk about it? Please, it was the day that I found out about the manuscript. I was really upset. I am never gonna see this guy again. Emmett, listen, let's just talk about it. Emmett.
I will not let you make me as crazy as you are.
Meet Alana.
You must be Alice.
Hi.
Sit. Alana is a fantastic conductor. Women really coming into their own in that field.
What about Maya, Dad?
I'm gonna see her. Yeah. Helene just needs a little time to cool down. Hey. You know how it is, right?
Suddenly started to just feel back.
Alice?
Excuse me.
Alice?
What are you doing here?
I brought food.
You know how precious sleep is to make.
Sadie.
Emmett is my friend, and Keith is our neighbor's kid.
Look, I'm sorry.
Good.
I brought Dolce de Leche.
And I love you more than almost anyone. Except Tyler and Rob and my mother, sometimes. I'm sorry not to like you very much. And I never forgive you for that. I need to not see you for a while.
What about the book?
Screw you, Alice.
You hooked up.
Yeah.
Was it wonderful? It should be wonderful, was it?
Mm.
Please tell me about it. Come on, how it was like. Did it make you come? I want to make you come. I want to be the first person to make you come. Look at me. Don't close your eyes. Open your eyes. Don't close your eyes. That's not the way we do it. Look at me.
It's just something that I do, that I've always done. I see that look in a guy's eyes like he wants me. I don't know. It's the only thing that makes me feel real.
I want you.
No.
So?
So it wears off. Like, I start wondering what's wrong with this guy. Why can't he do better?
It is unbearably sad.
I know.
But it probably can.
Yeah. I got a hose.
Cool. It's an ambush.
Where's my hat? I need to be protected.
Here you go.
I can't not be your friend for one more day.
I'm friends like you.
Honey, be careful. Figure if even you can't put up with me, I'm gonna have to do something about it.
Yeah. Better.
Aunt Alice! Emergency! Emergency! You're on fire!
I am!
Say help!
Help. Hi, my name is Alice Harvey. I am a volunteer for People for the People, and I'm calling you because this is such an important election, and it's so important that you've... Hello? Hey, you made it.
Of course.
Come on in. Hi, nice to meet you. Thanks for coming. Well, everyone, listen up. Let's take a little 5-minute break. Put your phones down. This is Emmett Grant, who founded People for the People. He is the guy that got us all here tonight. Woo-hoo!
I didn't get you here. You got yourselves here. Everybody take a look around the room. Forgot to thank our hostess for this evening. Thanks. Did you look around? It's a room full of people, right? See, we reached out to you. Tonight, you're here, you're reaching out to others, and then, with any luck, those others are gonna reach out on election day and fill in the right bubbles, and maybe, together, we can change the political landscape. If not, no, we can, because it's reaching out that matters. Reaching out that scares the shit out of them, even when our guys don't win. So please, please, just keep reaching out.
Woo-hoo.
Thank you.
Yeah. Awesome. That was a really nice speech.
Should have known.
Listen, I love you both.
We've got about 5 minutes.
How could you use this event for personal reasons?
That's not fair. I wanted to help you. I know how important this is to you.
Keep going.
Emmett.
No, actions have consequences, Alice.
Hey, we gotta move on.
I'm reaching out.
I have to go.
What would you like, sport?
I'd like to start with the arugula salad, please.
You know, the duck is fabulous here. You should try it.
I'd like the fillet.
Why don't you bring her the duck?
Come Milan. You want to tell them?
Nah, it's all you're doing.
Bullshit. Bookseller pre-orders for Waking Eyes. Unbelievable. We may have a bestseller on our hands.
Oh.
You're a genius, pal.
Haver's marketing department is.
Okay, so we're all geniuses.
Please pass the rolls.
Julio is good, but not if he doesn't have something great to sell.
Could you pass the rolls, please?
Could you just stop kissing each other's asses and enjoy the moment?
You have to be so crude.
Do you have to be so smug?
I'm happy. Not that you'd have any idea what that feels like.
I wonder why.
Actually, I'd like to stick to the fillet.
Okay, sport. Then duck for me. And a side of spinach. So, can anybody explain to me the appeal of that guy in that movie? Jeez, you know the one that won Best Picture.
I'll send it right over. Okay, great. Thanks. My agent said that you gave him my book.
Rental.
I'm not sure I did you any favors.
I was actually working on something new before all this, and I'd love if you could take a look.
Yeah?
It's my first chapter.
I'd love to.
Great.
Thank you.
Green Street is coming. Terrific. How many guests will that be? Okay, great. Thanks.
Alice?
He's just finishing up a call. He should be right out.
Could I take you to lunch?
Why?
Sorry to make you wait. Hot off the presses. One for you. One for you. Got the new dedication.
That's great.
Nice, huh? Come in.
Still, she haunts me, phantom-wise. Alice moving under skies, never seen by waking eyes.
Alan Daneker. He'll be reading from his new novel, Waking Eyes. Mr. Daneker.
Thank you, Martin.
Mm-hmm.
Sorry. She was slouching under the weight of a too big book bag, cracking her gum fiercely, like a line of defense. But her eyes cried out, "Love me. Oh, please love me."
A little lonely, she said.
My mom has no idea who I am anymore, but maybe she never did. She swayed with a graceful pas de deux, the dance of hate. She was small enough. She was invisible to them and always would be. Her eyes opened wider and wider as she came, brimming with surprise, pleasure, and ineffable sadness. Thank you.
Alice?
Fantastic night.
Yeah.
You're a natural.
No, I was terrified.
You were great. Wasn't he great?
Mm-hmm. Yes, it went very well.
I can't believe that woman from the New York Review of Books was there.
She was just interesting.
She was eating out of your hands.
Ben.
Alice, your mother told me what you said.
I had to.
Yes, I told him it wasn't true.
What? It isn't true?
That's what he said. I asked him. He said it's understandable.
Yeah. Like I told him, you maybe misinterpret something.
Is that what it is, Alice?
I think it's what you wish were true.
Alice? Stop the car.
It's perfectly natural to have feelings for someone who you look up to.
I'm flattered.
I don't know what to think anymore.
He said he may have used details from your life.
Writers are magpies.
To make the character more real.
Please stop the car! Alice? Alice!
Hey. What'd you do here? Are you okay? Alice? Are you all right? Oh, please, please. It's,
Is the new book?
Yeah.
Whose life did you appropriate this time?
No one. Well, there's bits and pieces here and there. Yeah.
Yeah.
It was such a long time ago.
What? What?
Alice.
It was such a long time ago. Concrete details. You must give me concrete details to make it real.
I know, at that age, little things seem enormous.
Your warm, heavy arms around me. The smoky taste of your tongue in my mouth.
I was helping you.
The feel of your heart on against my thigh.
But nothing really happened.
Yes, it did!
Yes, but you seemed to enjoy it at the time.
You were one of the few people who ever actually seemed to see me. To make me feel real and important.
But you are.
You used me.
Come on.
You abandoned me.
Alice.
You made me feel like I was nothing all over again.
Not nothing. It's a beautiful character.
I know. And I've been living in her shadow for 15 years.
What?
Come here.
Did Jeff screw up again?
No, I just got a Google alert.
Because I love you.
Gentlemen, how are we? Where's Alice?
I haven't seen her yet. Sadie!
Just show up.
Where the hell is Alice?
She had something better to do.
What?
Wait, who are you?
Her best friend. Are you Rach Fried, Mr. Doniger?
I am.
Want you to sweat? Well, some old lady with a slight beard let me in.
Mrs. Rayburn.
Oh. Emmett. I'm sorry that I hurt you. I might not be ready to take on the world, but I think that I can remember to think about one other person.
Yeah.
I'd like that to be you.
I'll think about it.
Okay.
100 was really good. You're the girl in the book, aren't you?